Well, we are joined today by meteorologist Nick Bender with our sister station KMBC in Kansas City. Nick, thanks so much for talking with us today. We're here talking about the upcoming total solar eclipse in early April. And out there in Kansas City, you are actually right in the epicenter of the last total solar eclipse that happened back in August of 2017. First, I have to ask, what was your experience during that?
Wow. Thank you so much for having me. I mean, y'all are in for a real treat. It was, I've seen a lot of amazing things in the sky over the length of my career. And that was probably the most amazing thing I've ever seen in the sky was the total solar eclipse here in Kansas City. There's just so many different things that you have to look forward to from the very beginning to the very end.
So, Nick, what was something about that eclipse back in 2017, living through it, something that either caught you off guard or just really surprised you?
Say the magnitude of it. I was at a high school, so I was with high school kids. You know, teenagers, they're really hard to impress. They don't get excited easily. And to see the face of the kids, jaws dropping, high fives when this happened, it was really special to be able to share that with the students there at the high school. Is up in Liberty, which is just northeast of Kansas City. I would say just one or two quick things that really took me by surprise was how dark and quiet it got as the shadow approached. It turned almost to evening. It got noticeably colder. The temperature actually dropped several degrees. It felt like evening. It looked like evening. I mean, all around the horizon, it looked like a sunset. So that was something. I mean, we knew what to expect. We knew what we would see from the sunset effect to the shadow to all the different features of the solar eclipse. But just to experience that and just to actually see it, I mean, it took a lot of people's breath away. There were some people that were kind of teared up a bit. It was an emotional experience for some there. It was incredible.
All right, a little preview of what we can expect in just a couple of days, really, April 8th. You can find the extended version of that conversation on WMUR.com and right inside the mobile app. And we have all the information for you to plan where you're going to be, your location on April 8th.
Very cool. And, you know, as we get closer, a lot of people watching the forecast. We're tweaking, we're fine-tuning, trying to nail down what exactly it's going to look like.
Yeah, we're hoping for a nice, clear, sunny day, of course. Still a couple weeks out, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. But definitely a cool thing if you're able to make it north where totality will happen. Not only does it get dark, but it's the rate that the darkness comes about so quickly, because it gets dark every day. But it happens so gradually. This happens in an instant, and so it really is cool if you can experience it.
You can take your glasses off, too,
during totality. Yes, those brief moments, you are able to be safe and take your glasses off, but as soon as, you know, the moon starts to move out of the way of the sun, you have to put them back on again.
Cool.
Very
cool.
So
a lot of different things to experience. So.